Just ends like that. Maybe the tape ran out. Who knows? That was a unreleased take from the Darkness on the Edge of Town LP called Down by the River, not to be confused with the future Down or by the River or the River song coming out in a couple years after that. But I decided to go back in and try to find some unusual cuts today. I did this a couple weeks ago, just outtakes and alternate takes of Bruce and Band. You are getting Loose with Bruce, heard every Monday here at 5 p.m. And it's a gorgeous pre-summer day. I hate to even call it spring because it's hitting near 80 out there. So it's finally a nice day. No storms today, but watch out tomorrow. I guess it's going to be bad for the next probably 2 or 3 days. So, like I said, wanted to play some outtakes and some other strange things I came across today. And the tour is chugging along over there in Europe. They just did Spain and Rio, the Rock in Rio Festival, something like 200,000 people, I guess. It was kind of a crazy, crazy event. There's footage of it, really nice HD footage of it, if you go on to YouTube. And somebody put the whole thing on one. I posted, I posted it in two parts on my Facebook page, which is WRLR98.3, Getting Loose with Bruce. So if you want to go on there and check it out. All right, next up is an alternate version of what would end up being one of his classics down the road, Jungle Land, which he tried all sorts of different ways and different versions before he settled on what would become the classic that it is today. This one is a version with strings. There's no sax solo in it. I think there's a little bit, but it's buried down in the mix. But the reason I kind of went with this, I think people have heard this before, is the quality of it. I just found it was like almost like CD quality. So let's give that a listen. This is Jungle Land alternate version.
1, 2, 3, 4. homecoming in Harlem late last night. Magic Rat drove a slick machine over the Jersey state line. Barefoot girl sitting on the hood of a Dodge, drinking warm beer in the soft summer rain. Rat pulls into town, rolls up his pants. Together they take a stab at romance and disappear down the road.
Spot.
soul engine won't be in a bit of silence, a soft refusal, and then footsteps echo down the hallway in the night. Little girl calls in the bed, shakes her head. With a kiss in the side, she said. And outside the streets on fire, in a reed of death wall. Between what's flesh and what's fantasy. But now the poet's dying, you don't write nothing at all. They just stand back and let it all be. And in the quick of the night, they reach for their moment and try to make an honest stand. But they wind up wounded, not even dead. Tonight, in jungle land.
Wow, what a difference. Not only the strings added, but the lyrics aren't finished. Obviously, there's a little in there. And there's no guitar solo. And I'm telling you, without those howls that he does at the end of the original, or the one that's made it onto the record, man, it's just not the same. But that's why it's kind of unique to hear. And I like playing some of these obscure takes and alternates, and like I said, decided to do that again this week. I did a couple weeks ago. So next one up is a song from that was left off Nebraska. I went in search of a Nebraska, the Electric Nebraska, and I guess it doesn't exist. That was pretty much, I shouldn't say exist, but it's not really out there. If anyone does know, get on my Facebook and leave me a message, because I'd love to hear. There's supposed to be full band versions of everything that ended up on Nebraska, and all the fans are hoping that someday that's going to come out, I guess. But this was a outtake that was left off it. This is called Losing Kind.
My name is Frank D, driver Dixie 109. I was out on Highway 17, just south of the Camden line. It was down there in the heart of Wilsonville, where I met my fate. She was standing outside the bar, said she was waiting for day. But I knew that that was just a lie. And I knew I was missing a losing kind. Well, I knew what we were both doing, and I knew can't win. But when the light turned green, I reached across the sea, popped the lock, and she slid in.
She said she liked Mexican music. She knew a place if I had the time. Well, we had a few drinks and we danced a while. I pulled her close, she didn't mind. Then what I knew kind of slipped my mind. And I couldn't resist her kiss with a losing kind. Well, we dove around in my Buick, getting drunk and having fun. Well, we ended up at the Space Western, out on Highway 101. Was around 3 a.m. we went out to this empty little roadside bar. It was there the cashier register was open. It was there I hit that guy too hard. But I knew when I hit him for a second time, it one attracts the other one, you're the losing kind. Grabbed her hand to get out of there, and I felt like I was gonna be sick. And a half hour later, the sleet started coming down, and that highway got pretty slick. I seen some lights in my rear view mirror. I guess I panicked and I gave her a gun. Well, then I wrapped her around the telephone. South on Highway 101. Well, she just stumbled out onto the bank and sat down in a pile. Well, I kicked out the driver's side window. But, buddy, when I got out, well, all I had to greet me was a highway patrolman's 45. He looked at the wreck and he said, "Son, you're lucky to be alive." Well, sir, I'll think that one over if you don't mind. Now, luck ain't much good to you when it's the losing kind.
I recorded December 1981 for the Nebraska album that, oh, look who just popped in. Who's just popped in?
I just popped in to give my opinion on.
Are you alive? Yeah, you are hot. There you go.
Yeah, I know what buttons to press.
Oh, you pressed. I was wondering because I didn't do it. What's happening?
Oh, you know, same old.
I was in the middle of my Nebraska talk here.
I know. Well, I wanted to join you. That's why I ran in.
He ran in. Did you ever hear that song? Losing Kind?
Is it on tracks?
No. It's never, from what I understand, it's never been put out before. But I was looking at this this website there. According to SpringsteenLyrics.com, which is a pretty nice site, there is no supposed electric Nebraska. It's just like supposedly right. Roy Bittan and Max Weinberg adding some piano and some percussion to some of the songs. So,
yeah, I mean, because from what I understand is they
I thought the whole band did at first, at what I was told, but not told, but what I had read at one point. But I'm sure there's people out there that know.
Yeah, secretly somewhere in a vault.
Yeah, in a vault.
A complete electric version.
And if they ever do put it out, I'm sure they'll just add some stuff to it, and there you go, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But what I wanted to say was I'm shocked that he could make such great sounds come from a four-track.
Yeah, that was a four-track recorder. I'm looking at a picture of it right now. It's
I don't know if all of our listeners understand what that means, but that's either a reel or
it's a small home tape recorder. It's like I don't want to say like a boombox, but I mean it was at the time a high-tech cassette recorder player. When I say high-tech, meaning you could overdub on it, you could take the same.
You had four different inputs where you could mix and match. So when you're actually listening to Nebraska, you can hear that there really is only four different instruments at any given time.
Yeah.
It'll be guitar and then
all by him.
Yeah. Yep. And it's just because that was the new technology back then.
And he was going to take that album into the band and they were going to make cuts out of it. And
they were
then,
like, this is perfect. What are you talking about?
He said, I'm going to put this, turn this into the record company. And they probably lost their minds.
Yeah, that's unprecedented.
Yeah, after The River. And I certainly remember the day. I vividly remember when it came out because I was working in a record store. And I even got to do a display for it on the wall. And we put it on in the store, and we're like, "Oh my God, what is this? After the River? This is what he puts out."
I mean, the opening track is about Charlie Starkweather,
killing people, But over time, it has taken on a whole new aura. Let's put it that way. So, in Down in Time, now it's considered one of the greatest moves in rock history to go and to turn your career completely around like that and release what you wanted to put out, not what you were expected to put out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
To go with your own heart.
Yep. All right. Next one up, another one I did not hear till it's so fun when I go around, I call it perusing the internet, looking for different songs, the stuff that, and maybe some of these I might have played. Now, granted, I've been out almost over 3 years. Maybe I played some of these. I tried to look. This was a greetings outtake from way back. This is Lady and the Doctor.
The lady keeps the doctor in a place inside her pocket, in a circle made of silver like a bee. The doctor gives a strange love, but the lady, she don't knock it. She's glad to get a piece of anything. The lady to see. The doctor keeps the lady in a page in a book on the history of communicable disease. The lady's been to school. She lets the doctor play it cool. He writes the script, she follows his lead. 'Cause the doctor writes a love story so fine. And the ladies learn. House calls where he visits the animals in their stalls, shoots them full of juice, and then goes home. The lady hits the supermart where she rides the aisles in a shopping cart till she feels she's played enough the part to get by. To
just be good. But the doctor has this need to be understood. The doctor feels he's so abused, and the lady feels she's so unused, and demands the doctor tender daily parts. Oh, but the doctor, he just can't do it, 'cause long ago the lady blew it, and they're too old now to make another star. The lady feels the doctor's made of stone, but the doctor's heart, it just ain't found a home.
WRLR.
You're listening to WRLR LP FM 98.3.
Thank you much, Liam. And I still want to talk like that guy, WRLR.
Oh, Jeff Dose. He's got such a great voice.
Yeah.
I wish we all had English accents on the station.
Yeah. Hello, this is Getting Loose with Bruce.
I was listening to the tail end of one of his shows, maybe this 60s one.
Yeah.
And he's talking about Winko Pinkas.
Winko?
Winko, they're like beetle boots.
Oh. You
know, just like the
pickle. Yeah, the pickle. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Winkle Pickers.
Winkle Pickers,
but
yeah, right.
He said it so awesomely that...
And the Cuban, they had the Cuban heeled boots.
Of course, I mean, like Springsteen.
Did you see the new movie that's coming out? I think you. I posted it on Facebook.
The documentary
by Ron Howard.
Yeah,
I can't wait to see that.
I mean, if anyone's going to do a Beatles documentary,
yes, someone that was there, and it's a good director. Right?
That's what I'm saying. I trust him with doing the Beatles.
Yeah, so that'll be kind of neat to look forward to. This week, and also Memorial Day weekend, hope everyone's got some nice plans. Hopefully it's going to, the storms will all be gone by then. Saturday, May 28th from 6 to 9, we've got the classic car show out there at the Dog and Suds again. We'll be doing a live broadcast. WRLR will be, not me and Tyler.
I wish.
Yeah, I'm working. Sorry, guys. That's a live broadcast from Rollins Road and Washington Street there in Ingleside. So come out and see some cars. Hear the WRLR. Boy, I can't talk today. That's been
WRLR.
I have to say it like Jeff Kemper. WRLR. And our crew, here's some music, plenty of Dog and Suds foods. Have a great time. Meet the wild dude, Mark Shanahan, which is always a treat. And maybe he'll buy you a hot dog.
making promises.
Yeah. And due to limited seating, please bring a lawn chair if you would like to. So, and then the other thing happening this weekend is at the Cultural Civic Center. The Illinois Brass Band is playing Sunday the 29th at 2 p.m. That's over on 2007 Civic Center Way here in Round Lake Beach, Illinois. And if you need more info on that, call 847-201-9032. So, yes, I can read a PSA, Tyler, when I feel like it. No, I know. I just can't say the name of the station.
Actually, I walked in and I was like, hey, Ray, you know what you can't do on the air?
What can't you do?
Read promos.
That's
and
right.
Prove me wrong.
I need one bad still. Those are promos, but I still need a spot one of these days.
Yeah, I got to redo mine because of that that I say noise incorrectly.
Noise? What do you say, noise?
I say noy the second time.
Oh, garage noy.
Me and
it's a singular show.
Exactly. Me and the co-host make fun of it constantly.
Yeah. All right, let's get back to the show. Getting Loose with Bruce, WRLR 98.3C, get right there. Boom, boom, boom.
There you go.
Yeah. And this outtake, now this is interesting. I, again, found this very interesting. I did not know this existed. Born in the USA, of course, has many, many different versions out there. I could find at least three to four standard ones that you hear all the time, standard being the one that was released, the acoustic version. There's another, a different acoustic version that I found today that's just a little bit different. But this one, very interesting. It's 8 minutes long, so this is going to take up some time. It's the alternate Born in USA with a ton of extra musical portion in there, and quite interesting. Great little guitar stuff in the middle, and some more, I guess, whatever they were playing, synthesizer there at the time. So let's give that a listen. Born in USA.
Just a
All right. Wasn't that awesome?
It was very cool.
And you wondered how they got 8 minutes out of that.
Yeah, I was wondering, and I had my question answered.
Yeah, lots of nice, some good solo stuff in there. Solo being Bruce on that Waylon guitar toward the end, and Danny going along on that synthesizer. Very cool stuff. All right, now this one doesn't fall into the same category as the rest, but I've had it in my head, and I haven't played it in a long time. Long time being like 3 months. Came out in October. Up till October, it was never heard of. Right?
Ooh, I wonder which one it's going to be.
You know what I'm going to play, don't you? Yeah.
I'm not going to guess.
Yeah, all right, whatever. It was, like I said, before October of last year, it was no one had ever heard of it. And then all of a sudden, boom, it appears on the River Box set. This is Straight Bullet.
Over these dark hills I'd walk around.
You know, that song has become like one of my all-time favorites.
That's how I feel about Meet Me in the City.
I feel robbed. Like 30 years you waited.
Right?
35 years.
Not even on Boots, not even anywhere.
But then grateful that it came out. So you got to look at it that way.
Of course.
Right? I was going to sneak one other one in, but no, I think I'll stay with what I got here. This was interesting only in the sense that, again, never heard this, and it's only somebody tagged it as the shortest song in his catalog. Now, that was, what did we play last week? Held Up Without a Gun.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Held Up Without a Gun.
This clocks in at a minute, but really? I say it's a minute only because it's not finished is what it is.
Oh,
to me,
okay.
It's just that's what it sounds like. So you're going to recognize the melody. Don't look. You see it already, didn't you?
No.
The melody.
I don't cheat.
No. The name is Eloise. Okay? Did you ever hear that? I never heard of that one. Let's give that one a listen. You'll know right away what it is.
Well, what power of God does a nun use to hold a parish priest? And what makes a good cop let go a beautiful thief? Oh, and how does the queen know she can hold that man with honey? Oh, and what makes an old woman give a young man all her money? Well, late in the 90s and pale moonlight, that power comes over.
See, I just say it's just not finished. It ends like it's supposed to end,
right?
But it's not complete.
Right, it's got one verse.
But yeah, growing up, I never knew there was anything prior.
No, this is all stuff you found out in the past
20
week.
Week? I started this morning.
Hey, I make my playlist the same way.
I know. I just, like I said, I have I've been having trouble lately deciding what I want to do, and I don't know why, but a lot of it's maybe got to do with the job. Now I'm working a little bit more than I used to, so the all of a sudden I get down to the day, and it's like, oh, I don't have a show plan. So I just kind of go for it and see what's what. I was going to play a lot of that a show from Barcelona this past weekend. It's all out there to play, but yeah, it's like a greatest. He's doing a greatest hits thing over there right now. Nothing really all that unusual, you know.
Okay, well, so, you know, for next week, we did talk about the...
you got some... it looks like you got some outtakes, or not outtakes, but recordings from back in the day.
Recording. It's the 75 Bottom Line show, and then I have 78 Roxy. I'll re-listen to them, see what the track list is.
But... No, I'm going to also look out there to make sure that it's not, like, in pristine form, you know, out there, too.
Well, I mean, of course, it probably is.
It could be. I don't know.
On YouTube,
but... Knowing how people are now. All right, last one of the day. This one's got some extra stuff added to it that did not make the final cut, mostly in the background, a lot of extra saxophone and stuff like that. What do you got coming up on your show?
Well, I've got everything from the Velvet Underground, the Lemons, to the Jam, to the Ramones, even the Grateful Dead.
Grateful Dead, huh?
It's a nice day out.
A dead day. It's a dead day.
Dead day.
Yeah. Oh, and I got a two second moan and groan I want to rant about. YouTube, now I'm well, this is a radio station where we actually pay royalties, et cetera.
Right.
For playing these songs and playing songs, and they refuse. They took my show last week because I remember when I played that 2 minute little snippet of that Jolie Blonde and took and they blocked my show in multiple countries.
That's ridiculous. That's
and
I
very irritated. And I put the copyrights at the end of the when I put all the credits and stuff. I need to find another way, whether it's going to be podcast or it's got to be SoundCloud or
see SoundCloud scans it. Too. Like it'll you can actually watch it when
really?
You upload your songs, and so I had like The Ventures as my opening song.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, this is The Ventures.
They make you change it?
But there's a website called archive.org that you can upload anything to, and that's what I've been using for my episodes.
All right, I'll have to look into it. But yeah, it's my little rant. You know, YouTube here, you know, I've got 150 7 shows on there now. And you know, I keep telling them, I said, this is a replay of a radio show. And they just don't, they just keep blocking it. I'm irritated. Rawr.
Get off your soapbox, Ray, and sit back
down. Get on my soapbox. All right, folks, thanks for listening. We'll be back again next week at 5 o'clock. And we're going to go out with one last outtake. And this didn't make it to the airwaves, I shouldn't say airwaves, but didn't make it out into the world until Tracks came out. And even on then, it was a little bit different version of it. This is TV Movie. Talk to y'all next week.
One, two, three, four. I woke up last night shaking from a dream. Or in that dream I died. My wife rolled over and told me that my life would be immortalized. Not in some major motion.
Listening to 98.3.